Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the last chapter of the microwave engineering. The chapter is titled Radar Engineering. So I hope it is very, very clear to you people from the last lectures that radar is the acronym for the radio detection and ranging. The various details for the two basic types, that it is the continuous wave, also called as the Doppler radar, and the pulse radar system we have seen so far. We have also derived the equation for the range calculation, that it is the distance between the target which has been detected and the source station where the radar is located here. To look at all these particular details respect to the operation of the radar systems, let us add some more information with respect to the very popular application, that is of the navigational use, hence this topic. So let us begin with. So here we begin with our topic. The topic is titled Radio Navigational Aids here. So here the radar systems are most popularly used for the determination of the navigational information with the help of the radio signal, of course, at the microwave ranges, we can say here. So the navigation in general, if we say, so this is our Earth, a spheroid here, and onto the Earth, so at any location, if you want to have the given information in terms of numbers, so most possibly we go for the references, the reference line which separates the Earth into the two hemispheres that we call as the equator, and the another reference that joins the North Pole to the South Pole passing through the Greenwich city. So this axis is called as the prime meridian. And with respect to these two lines, the location corresponding to this particular point is determined, and then we have the information in terms of the latitude and the longitude here. So the latitude, longitude along with the elevation. The elevation, that means if the person is above the ground plane or above the Earth's surface into the atmosphere at certain height. So that altitude is in the terms of elevation. So these three parameters basically nowadays we have in the terms for navigational information. So this is at the static location, and when the object or a person is into the motion, so that the three values, latitude, longitude and elevation, are all the changing values here. Now in this topic we shall describe how the radars or the radio navigation is made possible to have all these location changes and the further maps here. So if the target or the object is into the motion, so that time the very first of all the question is how to determine its particular direction. So that time the radar system is making the use of antennas. So for example, in this case we have the loop antenna. So the loop antenna is used for the direction measurement here or direction finding here. So this is the schematic diagram showing you the basic loop antenna structure. The loop antenna is for PQRS here. So PQRS, the four corners forms these particular loops. The physical dimensions of the loop antenna are denoted as small a by small b here, whereas this is the orientation of the loop antenna pointing towards north here, and here we have the east and west direction. This will be the south here, and this is the feed to the antenna here. Now with respect to the horizontal axis from west to east here, if the vertical alignment of the antenna is rotated, that can be marked from the original E up to the E2. So the angle value is theta. So these changes are also helpful in determination of the navigational direction here. So when the voltage level is represented for the loop antenna by capital E suffix L, so this is the phasor diagram giving the information with respect to the voltage level for the loop antenna. So these are the two phasor components, we can say. So I write here phasor diagram, whereas this is the diagram of the polar diagram here. So corresponding to the PQ and RS, we have this polar diagram, that is like the 8 into the transverse view, we can see here. Now when the loop antenna is used for determination of the direction and to having these phasors or the polars, I can say, from the second diagram, there it is the possibility of confusion. So that time the alignment can also be changed, the additional another antenna can also be used for the purpose of direction finding there. So whatever the EL that we had represented into the previous schematic diagram, so the voltage level VL if general in represented here, so that time here it is the account of another voltage level represented VV here. So VV accounts for the vertical type of the antenna. So these are the two voltages VL and VV that are into the phase quadratures. The polar diagram that has been recently shown to you people for the combined vertical and the loop type of the antenna will be helpful for determination of the direction and finally for the navigation purpose there. Now the determination of direction with the help of the loop antenna sometimes also fails. The reasons may be due to the imperfect types of the polarizations. So therefore the another techniques are also possible to have the navigation made possible. So the another alternative, we can say, this is the direction finding with the help of ad hoc antenna here. So in this diagram you can see the three forms of the ad hoc antenna. The ad hoc antennas are the special type of the antennas. This antenna dispenses the horizontal members and uses the pair of the vertical lines that have been connected to the receiver by the well shaded balanced pair of lines. So these are the antennas which are also useful for the determination of direction of the object here. So whatever the helical loops and the connectivities you see here, so these are nothing but the parts of the antenna for the radiation and the reception purposes here. So here we are trying to give you the brief information with respect to which the radars are helpful for navigational applications here. Now, as we are well familiar with the GPS, global positioning system, the navigational system here, the GPS, the four satellites are the minimum four signals from the four satellites out of a constellation of the 24 satellites of GPS system can be giving us the information with respect to the latitude, longitude and that of the elevation here. Now, there are certain another navigational systems also used for the same intention. So for example, we can have the LORAN system. So the LORAN here stands for the long range navigational aid here. So the long range navigational aid here, it is supported to have the values in terms of the hyperbolic systems. So here we have the LORAN system, the LORAN that is standing for the long range navigational aid system. So here it is based on to the hyperbolic system here. So in the diagram also you can see the different kind of the hyperbolas corresponding to the nodes we have represented A, B, C and E. So here we have the measurements of the distances, the angles and the elevation in terms of the hyperbolic values in this particular system. So as like the GPS, this also works for the same intention. The another names of the navigational systems are also, we have Deka system, Omega system are also there. So these are also giving us the various values. So as we know, using the radar system, the radar transmitting antenna is continuously sending the electromagnetic signal onto the objects or into the nearby surroundings, where the interception is by the objects that are reflecting a part of electromagnetic wave back to the receiver direction there. So from that, the information with respect to the range, the angle and the elevation along with the velocity value is determined here. So one of the subtype into the LORAN here, LORAN C system, is giving us the pulses in this particular form. The arrangement of the pulses are as such: we have the first pulse that is called as the master pulses, and rest of the groups are called as the slave pulses, arranged like this. The intervals of time in between are represented as 2 milliseconds and 1 milliseconds. The corresponding the TX, TY and TZ intervals for these groups of the pulses, the master and the slave pulses, are also represented here. So the motive of this particular lecture was that the radar systems, the radar antennas, can work to have the navigational information calculated, whether the object is into the stationary condition or is into the motion here. The another details for all these particular navigational systems can also be found here. So by the next lecture, with this brief conclusion, we shall be addressing the last topic for the chapter as well as for the subject here. And the topic is titled as radar antennas. So I hope you shall continue for the next lecture and will have the benefit of the microwave engineering subject. So for more such information and the details in all, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.